Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. It's another video, another celestial tour. In today's video, I am going to talk about the life cycle of a star. So before we begin, I am going to talk and give you some facts about stars. So, as you know, our sun is also a star too. And like I said in the previous solar system video, it is a yellow dwarf. And just like the sun, there are billions of other stars in our galaxy, which is the Milky Way galaxy. And if you ask how many stars there are in the entire universe, don't freak out, but the number of stars in the universe are basically more than the number of sand grains on Earth, which is about 1 septillion stars. And every single of them has their own star system with planets orbiting around them. So now that you learned about the background information about stars, let's begin the video without wasting time. So the stars are starting to be born in some galactic clouds of gas and dust, which is a stellar nebula. Now the lifespan of a star depends on its size, mass, and how fast they burn fuel. Now, the next thing that happens is that the morning star can be two-typed, either an average star or a massive star. Now, things are going to be like one of those choose-your-own-adventure stories. Like, you know, there are two options given to the reader about what will happen next. Now anyways, the average stars, like the sun, lasts about several billion years because they burn fuel slowly. However, the massive stars last only a few hundred thousand years. However, both of them eventually will begin to run out of the hydrogen fuel that powers the nuclear reactions in the core of a star, and the stars will enter their final phases. As time passes, they will expand, cool down, change color, and the average stars will become red giants, and the massive stars will become red supergiants. The red giants will have a peaceful death while passing through a planetary nebula to become a white dwarf. And the white dwarf cools down, stops glowing, and technically becomes a black dwarf. On the other hand, the red supergiants will have a worse and much more energetic end, which will become an incredibly huge explosion, which is called a supernova. Now, when the dust clears, the only thing that is left from the supernova would be a pretty dense star, which is a neutron star. And these can also be known as pulsars. If the red supergiant that exploded and turned into a supernova is even huger from an average sized red supergiant, it can even form a black hole, which are the creepiest stuff astronomers and physicists have discovered, because they literally can swallow up all the matter and energy. Not even light can escape, I'm telling you. And we will talk about these monsters in another video with more details. So, it is the end of the video. And I hope you learned something about the life cycle of a star and enjoyed it. The source I've used is in the description. Also, the definitions of the astronomical vocab words you didn't understand is also in the description. So, thank you for watching and stay astronomical.